Hi, I'm Kelly, and today I will be showing you how to use the Schedule Planner feature on the Iowa State University website. The Schedule Planner takes the information from the classes you would like to take a particular term, as well as other consistent time commitments you may have, such as work schedules, club meetings, etc., and schedule options based on your needs. The first thing we need to do is go onto the Iowa State website. Then click on the Schedule of Classes link in the Student drop-down menu. You may notice that Schedule Planner is listed underneath Schedule of Classes on the left side of the page, but we will not start at Schedule Planner. We need to start our journey with the Schedule of Classes because this is where we will go through the process of selecting which courses we will need. First, select the term you would like to plan, then the subject, then either the course number or course level. I will be selecting only course levels for the purpose of this tutorial because there is more information given when you select a course level instead of a course number. Now you will need to click search, and all 200 course level classes show up for industrial design. Underneath the search button will show you how many classes are offered, followed by a listing of those classes. You'll notice that each class has its own box. At the top of each course has a course code and course name. Notice that each course code is in red, presenting it as a link, which when clicked on will give you the course description. We can X out of the description and you will notice that underneath that is a lot of important information. There is a list of prerequisites if there are any, a note, such as a notification that only certain majors may take this class, and these pieces of information are then followed by the different sections. Within each section is related information such as the section number, section code, amount of credits, seats open, a link to textbook information, the meeting dates, the meeting days, meeting time, the professor, room number, as well as material information and fees if applicable. Right now, the sections aren't too important for the function of Schedule Planner, because a lot of what goes into which section you choose primarily has to do with how it fits into your schedule time-wise. Now, since Schedule Planner processes this information for you, it isn't necessary for you to look at it now. What is important to notice is that the Add to Schedule Planner button is only attached to the box of the class as a whole, not the individual sections. This is because Schedule Planner processes times for you and provides you with all possible schedules with all possible times, thus making it unnecessary for you to choose any sections individually at this point. You can go through and select all other classes you would like for the planned term. Once you have chosen all the courses you would like to take, you can then select Go to Schedule Planner. You'll see that at the top it shows you which term you are looking at, and underneath that is the list of classes you selected with different actions you can take as well. As in this case, if all sections for the classes chosen conflict, then this notification will show up. As you can see, it says you can check the sections and see which class is a conflict. I know that Industrial Design 201 is the problem for me, and let's say I don't need this class. If I already know this, I can remove it by clicking on the red X to the right of the class title. When you click on this, a pop-up will appear asking you if you are sure you want to remove the class, and click Continue. This, in reality, should fix the schedule conflicts, but as you can see, it still says no schedules are possible. If you get rid of a class this way, you have to click Generate New Schedules for the problem to be fixed so you can view your new schedules. If you don't know which class is causing you problems, then you can click Return to Schedule of Classes. Now you can search the classes you are going to check. When you check the courses, you'll see that the Add to Schedule Planner is now removed from Planner. So when you find the course you would like to get rid of, select that option. This time, there isn't a pop-up to double-check your decision. Now I've removed two of my five classes, so I'll go ahead and add another. And now we'll look at the updated planner. Underneath the Generate New Schedules button is the Schedule Summary. This has a list of your course, reference number, meeting dates, meeting days, meeting times, and credits, followed by how many total credits you will be taking. Again, the course code is a link which will bring up the course description. Following the summary is a view of what your schedule would look like. It is important to note that Schedule Planner is just that, a planner. It does not register you in any actual classes, but just pieces together a possible schedule. If you scroll back up to the top of the summary, you'll see it says 1 of 18 schedules. Since Schedule Planner filters through all the sections for you, instead of choosing one, it presents to you all possible schedules. You can go through each one of these by clicking the Next and Previous buttons. So here are all the schedules possible for classes that have their seats open. Let's look back up at the first list of classes we have at the top, and you'll notice that the blue box says, Add Sections with Open Seats. Schedule Planner defaults to showing only classes with open seats. Let's say you have a specific time you would like to be in class, but that section is full and you would like to monitor this schedule. Then you can click on Add All Sections. You can do this with as many classes as you find necessary. You can also click on Remove All Sections, which would theoretically be the same as clicking on the red X, but this way you don't have to remove the class. This is helpful if you want to compare what your schedules would look like with or without those classes. So far, you've seen that you can click on All Action Options, but if you click on the last one, or expand to add or remove sections, is not a button, but instruction. This allows you to pick and choose which sections you would like to consider, not by selecting these words specifically, but by clicking on the red plus sign at the left of the course name. All sections will then drop down from the title. If a class is selected, it will be encased by a gray box and have a red check mark. If a box is not selected, there will be no box and no graphic. To get rid of the sections, click on the red minus next to the course title. Now, if you work during the year or have weekly meetings or any form of time commitment you know will be consistent throughout that term, you can block off that time in Schedule Planner. You can do this by clicking the Add Reserve Time and put in times you need blocked off and click Create. You can also add reserve times by clicking on the time on the actual schedule and dragging the box down to fit the time you must block off. If you need to edit or delete a reserved time, go to the schedule and left-click on the time, which will give you the option to edit or delete the reserved time. If you want to get rid of all reserved times you entered, you can click on the link Clear Reserved Times at the top right of your schedule. If you find a schedule, or several schedules, that you are happy with, the gold star next to the number of schedules there are presents to you the link to the schedule. You can save that for yourself to look back on when you register for classes. Again, Schedule Planner does not register you in any classes, but only plans possible schedules. If you need help registering for classes, there is a link to the registrar's website in Schedule Planner over here. Otherwise, there is a video showing you step-by-step how to register for classes, and the link to that video will be in the description below. That is how you use the Schedule Planner feature, thus concluding our tutorial for today. If you have any questions, please contact the Office of the Registrar.